हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी डिस्कस अबाउट शेक्सपियरियन ट्रेजेडी एंड द नेचर ऑफ शेक्सपियरियन ट्रेजेडी. इन अदर वर्ड्स, इट इज सब्जेक्ट टू स्ट्रगल ऑफ गुड एंड इविल इन द वर्ल्ड. शेक्सपियर्स प्ले इज नॉट अ ट्रेजेडी मेयरली बिकॉज इट ब्रिंग्स बिफोर अस द मूविंग पिक्चर्स ऑफ द हीरो एंड द हीरोइन इंटेल्ड इन द कॉइल्स ऑफ डेथ एंड सफरिंग. Its characteristics motive is the exhibition of the man in unsuccessful conflict with circumstances. A tragedy is essentially a tale of death or suffering. Shakespeare tragedies are also powerful tales of death and suffering, but Shakespeare tragedy is something more than a mere story. Death and suffering, in the words of Dowden. Tragedy as conceived by Shakespeare is concerned with the ruin or restoration of the soul and of the other of the man. Shakespeare's famous tragedies. Shakespeare has left behind a number of tragedies such as Romeo and Juliet, Othello, Macbeth and King Lear. Among the Roman tragedies, Coriolanus, Antony and Cleopatra, and the Timon of Athens. Examine the fundamental characteristics of the Shakespeare tragedy and the return of the Shakespearean's tragedy. A tragedy of person of high degree. Shakespeare's tragedy is concerned with the fate persons of high degree, often with kings or princes and with leaders in the state like Coriolanus, Brutus and Antony. The dramatist does not concentrate on the lives of ordinary persons, nor does he recall the sufferings of the layman. In modern drama, tragedy is essentially the story of sufferings borne by the common man. What Shakespeare's was medieval in the conception of tragedy may have powerful effect on the reader's mind. Next, mainly a story of one or two persons. Though in Shakespearean tragedy there are number of persons, here the tragedy is preeminently the story of one person. Hero or at most of the hero, the hero and the heroine, the concentrations on the hero and the heroine, who generally come to witter and at the end of the play. The story leads up and includes the death of the hero. Next, suffering and calamity. Suffering and calamity that fall to the lot of the hero and not of the ordinary type. The suffering and calamity are always of exceptional characters. The hero has to pass through thorns of excruciating pain and suffering. The suffering is of such a powerful nature that it staggers and shakes the man, and the hero writers in the coils of insufferable agony. Hamlet, in the state of his vacillation, is literally on the rack. Othello, in the disturbed state of mind, finds a house, leaves, and Macbeth feels the pang of murdering the keep deep down in his heart till he feels that life is meaningless for him and it is all a tale told by an idiot full of sound and fury signify nothing. Next, cause of tragedy. The cause of tragedy in Shakespeare's plays in some fatal flaw in the character of the hero or the heroine. In the medieval conception of the tragedy, fate played an important part in bringing about the tragedy, but Shakespeare made man responsible for his own action. Tragedy, the hero is presented in the grip of some fatal flaw in his character, which in spite of external circumstances leads him to his fatal doom. Hamlet meets his tragedy because of his vacillating nature. Macbeth meets his end due to his overweening ambition. Othello is over-credulous and Lear is too rash. In the character, there is fatal flaw which ultimately brings about tragedy. Next, action. In addition to the voluntary actions or the characteristic deeds of the person, the dramatist introduced a number of non-voluntary actions which further accelerated the speed of tragedy. Next, abnormal condition of mind. As Shakespeare represents an abnormal conditions of mind such as insanity, as in the case of Lear, hallucinations, as in the case of Macbeth when he sees the iron dagger, somnambulism, as the scene of sleepwalking in Macbeth. The abnormal states of the hero and the heroine deep in the gloom of tragedy, they are not expressive of character. Introduction of the supernatural elements. Shakespeare introduced some form of the supernatural agents such as ghosts and witches, which are placed in the closest relations with the main character. Supernatural agents play their own part in influencing the life of the hero. The supernatural agents give a confirmation and distinct form to inward movements and inner workings of the hero's mind. The witches in Macbeth and ghost in Hamlet mold the character of the hero to some extent and prepare his tragedy for him. Next, the chance or accident. In the Shakespearean tragedy, chance or accident play its vital role. To ignore it totally in the tragedy is to distort reality. Several chance incidents happen in Shakespearean tragedies, which instead of averting the tragedy, hasten its speed. Tragedy is participated by chance happening. For example, in Romeo and Juliet, it is chance and just an accident that Edgar arrived at the prison just too late to save Cordelia's life. It was an accident that Desdemona dropped out handkerchief, which was picked by Emilia and inadvertently passed on to Iago. In Hamlet, it was merely a chance that the pirate ship attacked Hamlet's ship so that the prince was back in Denmark. But Shakespeare, in spite of introducing these chance elements in his tragedy, does not allow them to be so important as to destroy the sense to casual connection of character, deed and catastrophe. We came now to the hero of the tragedy. The heroes of Shakespeare's tragedies are exceptional beings in whom there is an intensification of life. The hero is a man of exceptional life, but he is governed by a predisposition in some particular directions. In almost all tragic heroes of Shakespeare, we observe a marked one-sidedness. The hero identifies himself with one interest, object, passion, or habit of the mind. Macbeth is the embodiment of passion, and Othello believes what he hears. In Hamlet, there is painful consciousness that duty is being neglected. Each hero has virtues above the average man, but there is no proficiency in which he is so engaged that the loses sight of their consideration. It is not always necessary that the hero may have virtues alone. Macbeth and Richard are no virtuous characters, but even to these wicked characters, Shakespeare gives something of greatness. Richard has power which excites astonishment, and Macbeth has courage which wins our admiration. A Shakespearean tragedy, in spite of its tragic and never depress us, though there may be heart-reading suffering, nor the hero, yet all through he leaves upon us the impression of greatness. Macbeth, in the last act of the drama of his life, redeems his character and makes the reader think highly of him. The spectacle of the Shakespearean tragedy is never depressing. The most confirmed cynic sees to be cynic while he reads this play. The Shakespearean tragedy produced two feelings: the feelings of pity. The manner in which the hero meets his tragic doom produces a feeling of awe in the hearts of the readers. When we find Macbeth meeting his end in encounter with Macduff, we are all awe stricken at his fate. There may not be strict poetic justice in the Shakespearean tragedy, yet your moral sense is never given also the villainies are generally punishment for the evil deeds. Macbeth, who had murdered King Duncan and had been responsible for many other murders, met his tragic in the end. Lady Macbeth also suffered because she had crushed her own nature. This villainy is published in the Shakespearean tragedy. It is very difficult for a villain like Iago and Edmund to escape unpunished. Shakespeare's comedies have been classified by Charlton into four groups: romantic comedies, comedies free from romanticism, lighter comedies, or dark comedies. Another classification of Shakespearean comedies has been early comedies, middle comedies, and late comedies. In early comedies, has comic quality arises chiefly from the language in the dialogue, from the wit and humor of the speech, and sharpness of tripartite, and a peculiar manner of expression called euphemism. In the middle comedies, the motive lies a little deeper, and comic situation and comic characters form the essence of the comedy. In the last group of comedies, the tone and spirit undergoes a change, and instead of the happy and joyous atmosphere of the earlier comedies, there are certain bitterness and cynicism. The late comedies. Shakespeare's wrote comedies in relief from the strain of tragedy. William Shakespeare wrote tragedies, but when he felt mentally exhausted, he sought for a mental relief and rest. Then he went to the fountain of a comedy of drink, the nectar of peace and relief. Forgetting the heaviness of tragic gloom, Shakespeare wrote the comedies when he was in most delightful and cheerful mood. The cause of tragedy in Shakespeare play in some fatal flaw, the character of the hero or the heroine. In the medieval conception of the tragedy, fate played an important part in bringing about the tragedy. But Shakespeare made man responsible for his own action, and he believed in the principal character's destiny. In each of his tragedy, the hero is presented in the grip of the some fatal flaw and his fatal doom. Okay. Thank you for watching.